Would you use a device that basically shuts your jaw closed and only lets you open it a fifth of a centimeter in order to lose weight? Well, that's what some people are promoting now, and it seems pretty ridiculous if you ask me, but it brings up a very interesting point about how do you handle people who struggle losing weight. I'm Dr. Brett Scher, the medical director at dietdoctor.com, and there's been a lot of news recently about reports from researchers from the United Kingdom and the University of Otago in New Zealand that they've developed this magnetic device that goes on your back teeth, your upper and lower back teeth, and the magnet keeps your jaw closed and keeps you from being able to open it more than a fifth of a centimeter so that you can only basically eat liquids. And they're promoting this as a safe and effective way for weight loss. Other people, kind of rightly if you ask me, are responding that this is barbaric and medieval and kind of ridiculous to promote this as a weight loss tool. And although I agree, it's sort of like similar to that the tube that goes in people's stomach. So you eat and then you go to the toilet and just dump it straight from your the food straight from your stomach. Basically like medical bulimia, and this is sort of like medical anorexia. So although I agree that those are sort of absurd and on the extremes, it brings up the question though of what do you do? How do you handle people who have a hard time complying with diet? And I got similar pushback against a recent podcast I did about weight loss surgery. People saying, you know, weight loss surgery is medieval and barbaric and shouldn't be considered. Where other people chimed in and say, yeah, but what do you do for people who cannot, or for people who really struggle complying with diet and need extra help? And that was sort of my point, that maybe I wasn't so clear enough about that weight loss surgery podcast to explore this option. I don't think it's for everybody. I think it should be used as a last resort. And that's sort of the point I was bringing across, that lifestyle first. And before you say you've tried everything, a very low carb keto diet with time restricted eating should be part of that. Try everything before you take extreme measures, whether it's wiring your jaw shut or undergoing bariatric surgery. But we have to be honest, not everybody flourishes with lifestyle. People struggle with lifestyle. Now, a big part of that is the message, right? If it's count your calories, exercise more, watch your fat intake, so you're eating bland food you don't enjoy and you're eating less of it and you're hungry all the time, that is a recipe for failure. Absolutely. So if that's what you've tried and you're not succeeding, the next step isn't bariatric surgery. The next step isn't a magnetic device to close your jaw or to just dump your food straight into the toilet. The next step is trying a different diet, trying a different pattern of eating that works for you, that you enjoy, that's sustainable, that improves your metabolic health, helps you lose fat mass while retaining lean body mass, and fits into your lifestyle. For a lot of people, that's going to be a low-carb diet, maybe a ketogenic diet, maybe a moderate low-carb diet, maybe a higher protein diet, but these are all part of the equation. So while I sort of laugh and shake my head when I read these news reports about this magnetic device to close your jaw, and I think it's absurd, it does bring up the issue of people are going to struggle with lifestyle, and what do? And you have to try other options. But a big point of that is other lifestyle options. So time-restricted eating by itself may be good. A plant-based diet that focuses on low carb and still has some factors to improve hunger control, it may be an option, right? There are lots of options, but the keys are improving hunger, making it sustainable, and helping you lose weight in a healthy way, not just losing lean body mass, but losing fat mass. So there are other options that we can go to that hopefully doesn't involve these extremes. And that's what we want to provide at dietdoctor.com. We're looking to provide all the resources you need to find the right dietary pattern for you. Now, that in itself has caused some confusion, because for the longest time, we focused on low-carb and keto diets. And we wanted to make that simple for people. But now we've added some nuance and some complexity to it that, okay, well, maybe just eating as much fat as you want isn't going to work for everybody long term. Maybe you need to reduce the fat, increase the protein, maybe even increase the carbs so you're not on a keto diet but more on a liberal low-carb diet. But when you introduce information like that, it can be so confusing because you say, how do I know what's right for me? And the keys are, if you're succeeding, if you're controlling your hunger, if you're happy with the way you're eating and you're losing weight in a healthy way, You don't need to change anything. That's the most important point here. If you're finding success, you probably don't need to change it. But if you're struggling, that's when you start to look for different options. And that's when you need to design your own little experiments to see what works for you. Now, we want to help you along that way as well, so you can use our personalized meal planner, answer some questions about yourself, and we will try and pick what we think is a good place to start. But that's a starting point, right? You have to be able to iterate upon it as you go, or find a health coach or a doctor or a clinician to work with, which you can also find on our website to give you more of that one-on-one attention. But the key is, there's not just you try something once and it either works or it doesn't. You have to be willing to evolve with changing science, with changing tastes, and with changing progress. You may see initial great progress, then stalls or reverses, and you have to be able to react to that. And we can hopefully provide you with the tools and the information you need to know as much as you need to know to be able to react to that. So you're not going to see me, you know, magnetically wiring my jaw shut anytime soon, and I hope I won't see you doing it either. But I do hope I will see you improving your health, reaching your health goals, losing weight in a healthy way if that's your goal, and doing so in a sustainable and enjoyable way. All right. Thanks a lot, everybody. You can always click subscribe and thumbs up down below and leave a comment. We'd like to hear from you. And we'll see you again next time on Diet Doctor News on YouTube.